Pretty big answer.
We've only got the four.
Two hours at least. The molecular gastronomy is a name that was invented by a Hungarian physicist so he could use a centre for a workshop in 1982-84. And it became associated with chefs who used pipettes, test tubes and other sorts of ingredients. So the bigger question is really, when is an ingredient natural or not natural, and if it's not natural, what does this mean, and is it acceptable? Also, you take the use of equipment. So let's say, you know, I'll deal with the equipment first. We embrace modern technology in everything that we do. We want our televisions to have better pictures. We want our motor cars to have better braking systems. We want our telephones to work quicker, be clearer. So why do we not embrace technology in the kitchen? So anybody that is resisting modern technology should only ever cook on an open fire. Because sometime in the past, sometime in history, electricity was groundbreaking, was shocking. It's meant to be a bad pun, by the way. So the kettle, or the food processor, shouldn't use it. Crazy modern piece of equipment. So we move on. It's okay to use a glass juicer to juice your lemon. It's okay to use a liquidizer to puree your raspberries. It's okay to use a vegetable juicer for your vegetables. What about this high-speed centrifuge for separating amino acids? Oh, hang on a second, that's a bit dodgy. Yeah? It's not the equipment. It isn't the equipment. It's what is it used for? And the same thing that goes with the ingredients. So at one point, if it's okay to use thyme, is it okay to use sugar? Sugar doesn't grow in grains. Sugar is processed. There's a commercial processing system to make sugar, and the same thing with salt. The same thing with gelatin. Garlic is a preservative. Vanilla, you have a natural vanilla, a vanilla pod, which has the smell. But the aroma molecule that creates vanilla is called vanillin. And it's exactly the same aroma molecule that exists in wine barrels, in wood. And the vanilla that comes to wine comes from the wood. Mm-hmm. It's the same molecule, it's the same compound. So there's always going to be a grey area. And there was a lot of ignorant adverse publicity a few years ago about these ingredients that were supposed chemicals. And the one in particular chemical that caused a problem was something called methyl cellulose. Now, I don't use it because for me I don't enjoy the texture of the food it produces. But methyl cellulose is used in hundreds of products we buy in the supermarkets, from biscuits to stews, in much the same way as gelatin might be used. So you imagine, like a food writer comes along and says, this is bad for you. The company that makes that product is a very large company that they could have sued. They could have sued and done some pretty big damage. They spend years getting these products sued to the market. So what you should be doing is trusting the law to say, not a journalist that says that. I think having said all of this, ultimately, for me, it doesn't matter how modern the equipment is, what ingredients are available. The chefs would always look to seek out the best produce. Work with the suppliers, the farmers, the fishermen. Also, and it's a really simple thing, just taste your food. Taste your cooking. It doesn't matter what kit you use, ultimately you have to taste the food and ask the question is, as a chef, surely you want to give pleasure to the person eating. And however you give pleasure, that's the most important thing. And it should come down to whatever the technique or the ingredient, it should come down to the pleasure you gain from the food. That's quite a long answer to your question, but for me, that's really short.